Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Corpse Lock coming to you with a quick video, probably not, but I'll try. It's been a while. I've been feeling very well lately, so that's probably why there's been a lack of content recently, but I apologize. I will try to get back to a normal content-producing schedule as soon as possible, but until then, please bear with me. Combat. That's what this video is pretty much about. Combat. Or, more specifically, the focus of combat. Now, before I start, let me say this. I understand the appeal of combat in games. It kind of is the drawing factor to most games, especially games that tailor themselves around combat. First-person shooters, MOBAs, real-time strategy games, even MMOs. Combat's an important integral part of certain genres, if not all genres, of games. Racing games have their own level of combat involved, and things like that, and even platformers have some form of combat involved, but it seems to me, though, that gaming developers seem to pigeonhole their game into a very specific role when it comes to playing as with combat. With MMORPGs, or RPGs in general, that seems to be the only thing there is to do, right? Now, again, don't get me wrong, combat is great and all, but there's so many other things you could be doing. Just in an RPG, for those of you who ever played Dungeons & Dragons, the tabletop role-playing game, which was an RPG, but it was tabletop, there was combat in the game, but it wasn't just combat. In fact, in most tabletop RPGs, if the DM who's leading the campaign threw nothing but combat and after combat scenario at you, it would be very boring. Now, granted, in a tabletop RPG, combat is nothing but a series of dice rolls. So that could be rather boring for some people if it was nothing but endless dice rolls with just positioning of characters on a board and killing. It has its moments, but it only has its moments when that combat means something. In most MMOs today, the focal point of the MMO is combat, whether it be PvP combat, PvE combat, but it's always combat, it's always fighting. And not that I'm trying to sound like some sort of pacifist or something where I think, can't we all just get along? No. In fact, I think that players should get along less. But there should be other avenues that that player can take. If I log into my favorite RPG, maybe that day I don't feel like fighting. Maybe I'm tired. Maybe I don't feel good. Maybe I feel like doing some various menial tasks that also help further my character or get involved in other ways. Now, granted, in RPGs, they have like crafting systems and fishing and cooking and things like that, but that's a very backseat type activity. There's very little to do in most MMORPGs that doesn't involve combat. And the reason why I find this to be a problem is because when you focus heavily on combat, the focus is then shifted to making that combat as fun as possible. And unfortunately, there's only so far you can take that without changing the dynamic of how MMORPGs are built from the ground up. Guild Wars 2 is a prime example of that, where a lot of people will clamor for the innovation of Guild Wars 2's combat in comparison to other games, or even Terra Online. They'll use Terra or Guild Wars 2 as a benchmark to say, well, look how their combat is, that's why these games are superior. But that's like taking a turd and polishing it up and saying, well, look how shiny it is, that means it's better. No, it's still a turd. Because what you've done is you've taken a genre of game that is supposed to encompass a lot of other aspects of gameplay and made it entirely about combat. And RPGs, by their nature, have always been relatively open-ended in terms of what you as the player can do. But when you're pigeonholed into a very specific role, such as your role is combat, you fight. That's what you do, you fight. It limits you, and it becomes very boring very quickly, very repetitive. Because you only have so many abilities. Fights can only have so many outcomes, and that's when the feeling of grinding or the boredom comes into play, because you log into a game. Let's just say I'm not even going to name games by name at this point. From this point forward, you log into your favorite MMORPG. It doesn't matter what it is. It really doesn't at this point. And you go to your favorite area of the game, or the area of the game that you have to be in to level, or whatever it is you're doing. And you have this list of abilities that at your disposal, okay? And what are you doing? Well, you move with your mouse, you click on the target, and you have to kill this target. And then the next quest or task or mission that's given to you, you have to go to this area and kill this target, and then kill this target. Combat is very centric to getting anything done in most MMORPGs, if not all MMORPGs, with a couple of exceptions. EVE Online, you could be completely combat free in that game if you wanted to, but again, even in EVE Online, that's very hard to do. It's very hard to get around in EVE without ever dealing with combat. They give you some avenue to do it, but it's very difficult to do. But most MMORPGs, other than EVE Online, fantasy-based MMOs, or even third-person isometric view MMOs, where you're out like the third person, it's typical, like WoW, Guild Wars 2. Even though I said I wasn't gonna name names, but you know what I mean. That whole you're running behind a character thing and you're killing stuff, that's all there is to do is combat. That's all there is to do. I think back to when I used to play Dragon Realms, for example. Now, Dragon Realms was a text-based game, and you had more options available to you in a text-based game than you do today with these graphical, technological wonders of modern MMOs, which don't have those options for you. And it's amazing to me the standard that gamers that we tolerate and claim that this is great, this is a good MMO. Well, how is that good? You're so pigeonholed into a specific role, you're pigeonholed into a specific activity, is what I mean to say. More accurately, you're pigeonholed into a specific activity. You are a fighter. It doesn't matter what your class is. It doesn't matter what your spell set is. It doesn't matter what your aspirations are in the game. You are a fighter. You get involved in combat. And I understand that fighting in video games is fun, but there's more to RPGs than just combat. At least there should be. And when there isn't, when you remove all of that fighting and from other aspects, when you remove the player drama and you just focus on combat, you have nothing more than a beat-em-up. It's basically a dungeon crawler. It's a dungeon slasher. It's like Diablo. Diablo 3, Diablo 2, whatever. Torchlight. Those games are hack and slash games. They're focused entirely on combat, and they're not really RPGs. Sure, in the very loose sense of the word, you're playing the role of a character that was designed for you, but you're really not making decisions. You're really not doing anything to further the development of your character other than leveling him up by killing endless waves of monsters. In MMORPGs, that still applies. You're really accomplishing nothing but killing endless waves of monsters. I mean, how many bear asses do you have to collect before you're done killing bears? Or how many bandits do you have to kill before you could stop killing bandits? I mean, surely the genocide of the bandit population in most MMOs, there should be no one stealing anything. I mean, if you think about it from a logical standpoint, who would want to be a bandit in most of these worlds that have, in most worlds that are MMO worlds? I mean, the career would be so hazardous. You'd be like, I want to go steal from those people traveling on the road. Wait a minute. Every day we lose thousands of our brethren to these magical, mystical people who happen to have all this godlike power. Maybe we should rethink our lives. Nope. Today is the day. I just wish that MMORPGs and the designers who make them would focus more on things outside of just fighting. And know that role-playing games, RPGs, that's what they are, they're role-playing games. There's more to it than just fighting. It's combat is a part of it, but if it's the only thing your MMORPG has to offer, that's bad. Because if that's the only way anything can get resolved, if that's the only way a player can advance, and if that's the only way a story can progress is through your concocted combat system, then there's a problem. And you've taken choice away from the player. So for those of you out there who are talking about how great the combat system is in this MMORPG or in this MMORPG, remember that you're talking about a system that is small to the overall fundamentals of what an RPG should be. You need to understand that there should be more to the video game world than just, especially when it comes to MMORPGs, than just right clicking and then tapping your keys and you know, being all I'm badass combat ninja pirate, you know, whatever. There, that's such a finite role, that's such a finite activity, and it really limits the possibilities of what MMOs could offer. And unfortunately, that's the only thing people look for in MMORPGs is combat. And it's sad, because there really is so much more you could throw in there that we'll never see. I don't think we'll ever see it, because people have a very narrow field of vision for what they think an MMORPG should be about. Maybe it stems from games like Call of Duty and Diablo and Torchlight and whatever, that if they're not cutting somebody in half or setting them on fire, then there's nothing else to do. Well, there actually is a lot to do, but we'll never see that. Anyway, I'm starting to ramble now, but that was just wanted to get that out there. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, sorry, I'm more updates. Like I said, I haven't been feeling well, but hopefully soon I'll be able to get you more regular content. In the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, this has been Corpse Slot, and I'm kind of a big deal.